You receive an order for 250 micrograms IM. The medication is available as 1 milligram per 2 milliliters. How many milliliters will you give the patient? To solve this problem, we're going to use a proportion, which is formed by setting two rates or ratios equal to each other, as we see here. And as long as the units of A and C are the same, and the units of B and D are the same, then A times D will always equal B times C. So if we have one unknown, we can solve the unknown using this equation here. So looking at the given information, we'll start with a known rate of 1 milligram per 2 milliliters. So we'll have 1 milligram is to 2 milliliters as we have 250 micrograms is to an unknown number of milliliters, we'll say x milliliters. But notice in this form we cannot cross multiply and solve for x. The reason for this is because looking on the top, we have different units. Here we have milligrams, and here we have micrograms. So we need to convert either milligrams to micrograms or micrograms to milligrams. To do this conversion, we'll go ahead and use the fact that 1,000 micrograms is equal to 1 milligram. So for this problem, let's go ahead and convert milligrams to micrograms. And again, because 1 milligram is equal to 1,000 micrograms, we can substitute 1,000 micrograms for this 1 milligram. This would give us the proportion 1,000 micrograms per 2 milliliters must equal 250 micrograms to x milliliters. And now notice how we have the same units on top and the same units on the bottom. So now we can cross multiply and solve for x. When cross multiplying, we'll go ahead and leave off the units. So we'll have 1,000 times x, that's 1,000x, must equal 2 times 250, that's 500, dividing both sides by 1,000. So we have x equals, this would be 1/2 or 0.5. So you would give the patient 1/2 or 0.5 milliliters. I hope you found this helpful.